Hello, my name is Carol. I am with the hunger management team. We are glad to introduce an essential metabolic process called autophagy from the book Hunger Management by Dr. Bruce Thompson. A growing awareness of this term is occurring across multiple media platforms. A term coined in the 1960s describes how microscopic cells utilize internal sources for growth, development, and energy. Scientists are studying the rejuvenating effects of autophagy induced by calorie restriction. Autophagy plays a significant role as a catabolic process that confers beneficial effects during food scarcity or dietary restrictions. Now, I will turn it over to Christopher and Guy, also members of the team.
Hello, my name is Christopher, from the Hunger Management team. Today we are discussing a cellular metabolic process called autophagy. The process of using our cells' internal energy sources is extremely important. Autophagy describes the process where sources within the cells are transformed into energy or recycled into new structures. It is an adaptive response to food scarcity, energy balancing, and cellular development. This term is quickly on its way to becoming mainstream within the next few years. Autophagy also restores vitality to cells, making them more efficient. Eating too frequently may harm cells by the accumulation of metabolic debris and untapped sources of energy. It requires about 24 hours of fasting without exercise to activate this beneficial process. Physical activity can start this process in a shorter time.
Hello, my name is Guy. You should know that there's a connection between the buildup of such metabolic debris and diseases like Alzheimer's, Parkinson's disease, infections, and other metabolic disorders. Fasting, hunger, and strenuous exercise start the process of metabolic switching and autophagy that improves the chances of a long, healthy life. Researchers have made substantial progress uncovering dietary restrictions mechanisms, biological consequences, and benefits over the past two decades.
Metabolic switching and autophagy initiates and improves a broad range of cellular activities that regulate anabolic and catabolic pathways. This includes metabolic pathways that produce energy, regulate metabolic byproducts, and reduces the risk for cancer development. We have exited the period in our history when anabolic metabolism from eating too frequently could be synonymous with good health. Over the past two decades, we have made substantial progress, shedding light on the biological mechanisms and benefits associated with dietary restrictions. Dr. Thompson describes several common themes that have emerged from scientific research of fasting, such as metabolic switching, reduced risk for cancer development, and initiation of autophagy. In December 2019, a review article was published in the New England Journal of Medicine about the effects of intermittent fasting on health, aging, and disease. In summary, deriving energy from our fat cells has a consistently positive impact on health spans across a wide variety of species. We have many adaptive cellular responses passed down through countless generations that improved bodily functions, including glucose regulation, stress resistance, and reduced inflammation, all of which have entered aging benefits.
Intermittent fasting and time-restricted feeding are dietary restrictions that prompt critical areas of the body to undergo stress resistance and flexibility. During a fast, our bodies begin to switch to hunting mode. The optimum function of the person is required to improve the chances of enduring the strenuous nature of this event, to capture and consume food sources. Today, people eat too frequently, thus preventing this metabolic switching. Intermittent fasting includes several strategies that are growing in popularity, like time-restricted feeding. Copying aspects of our ancient environments is a novel approach that provides us with remarkable advantages for survival. The relationship of hunger to fed states has been balanced on Earth over countless generations. With the introduction of agriculture, things began to change. Now, years later, the balance is being challenged by the constant fed state of modern times. By understanding the dietary practices of our ancestors, understanding like the food they consumed, the amount of energy they spent, and how often they ate, we can learn to live healthier adaptive lifestyles. There is a growing interest in such ancestral lifestyles, food varieties, and hunting activities by researchers trying to uncover their diet and physical conditioning. Such studies revealed that exercise and fasting would upregulate autophagy to remove damaged proteins and recycle their components. Eating the best types of food with vital levels of nutrients and low calories, fasting, hunger, and strenuous exercise is ideal.
As you read more, you'll learn how our body responds to hunger by activating autophagy to produce energy from elements inside the cell. It is like using all the trash leaves and fallen tree branches in the backyard to build under the stress of winter. The result is that you keep warm and have a clean yard leading to the spring season. Likewise, this process cleans debris from within the cells, leaving the cell revitalized for growth and harmony comparable to springtime. Aging is characterized by the gradual weakening of cells and organs due to buildup of debris from macromolecular and organelle damage. The continuous removal of trash-like components and replacement with new structures delays the aging process. So, autophagy is a housekeeping function of our cells. We live in the age of human overconsumption and excessive anabolic metabolism from eating too often stresses our bodies to the tipping point. Your understanding will increase as you intellectually digest more of the information in this book. No pun intended. Well, maybe, I can't help myself sometimes. It seems that humor is all around us. Nature is not without a sense of irony. Especially when you heard all the times your mum said, tomorrow is trash day. Maybe in the future, we will say tomorrow is autophagy day.
We hope you enjoyed this very important topic. For more information and discussions, join us at the Facebook group, Hunger Management Society, or visit www.hunger-management.com. From the Hunger Management team, live long and prosper.
Live long and prosper.
Live long and prosper.